Good morning. It's the Wednesday glow, and you are certainly looking at something with a lot of glow. What is the glow? Getting tapped in, tuned in to your environment. And what is more beautiful than art and acting as a form of creative expression, joy, and Wednesday glow? And today, I have the incredible honor to share with you an actor and famous artist in the making, has been making, Pepe Serna. Pepe Serna has been featured in over 100 films, including Scarface, which I'm going to be talking to you about. Isn't he just the cutest thing ever? And I can't even, like, what, 300 something TV shows?
Right.
Art is, you're looking at some of it. So Pepe, oh my gosh, tell us about this. Look at this, you guys, this is incredible.
This is really the creation that created me as an artist was my wife, Diane. And she always had the color for using colors and decorating. And this particular painting is my homage to all the Mexican movie stars and singers.
Because you are... Latin yourself, correct?
Mexican-American, Texican. And it's what I grew up with, and what kind of inspired me to be an actor was watching them as a kid. They called it the las películas de oro, the golden era of film in Mexico, the 30s and the 40s.
I understand that you said one of your famous quotes was something like, I'm always either being killed or...
Mostly being killed. Killing. That's how they use us as Latinos, and they still do.
And that happened in Scarface, right?
Yes, in Scarface, which was an incredible movie where I played the part of Angel Fernandez. And they, on the first drug deal after coming here, the Marelitos, that Castro sent all the convicts over to Miami, and that's what we were. The convicts, and on the first drug deal, I meet my demise at the hands of a Colombian drug lord who saws my arm off with a chainsaw.
Wow.
So it was the bloodiest scene in the history of film at the time. And since then, it's been topped, right?
So but, have you, your wife pretty much inspired you then to get...
Yes.
Wow, that's beautiful.
She, this is, I mean, they're all her and I in tropical locations. This is one of my serigraphs and posters that I sell called Paraíso, Paradise. And then I'll move on around so you can see more of the paintings. And as you can tell, this one here is El Gallo Blanco, the white rooster. And this one over on this side is an interesting one. It's a family in crisis where the father is having his last drink of alcohol, the last drops of his alcohol, and the wife says something and he goes to slap the wife, but the Virgen de Guadalupe comes in and moves her out of the way and takes the hit for the wife.
So there's a lot of meaning here because our Virgen has a lot in the Latin culture.
And all the son and the baby, everybody's pointing at him. And at one point, see, I had the son protecting his mother in the boxing pose. I was a Golden Glove champ. And I decided to break the cycle of violence by putting the Bible in his hand and the rosary in the other.
That's beautiful.
But for us... You know, living, coming.
Yeah, we're going to, this is part of his home, you guys.
Yeah,
how beautiful are we?
This is, you know, moving here, we lived on Balboa Island, and we needed more space. We needed to move my mother-in-law in with us. And so, as you can tell, my wife's decor is
is the love current, of,
yeah,
of
yeah,
art
yeah,
and
yeah.
The culture.
Yeah, and the documentary will be that life is art, and it's, as you can see here, all the, these are actual coconut faces made from the coconut, and everywhere where you look, it is there's art. Here's another one of my serigraphs, right here, and it's that's Honeymoon. That one is Honeymoon, and they're all available.
So can the public purchase any of these anywhere?
Yes. Right now, the website is being worked on.
Okay.
It should be bepasubna.info.
And I understand you're teaching somewhere as well, right?
I'm
helping students.
I have for 50 years the Pepified Breakthrough Improv to teach kids how to connect, communicate, and collaborate. And they are doing my documentary on my life, that life is art. And
life
how,
is art. And get that, everyone?
That I've been an actor since I was 3. I knew that I was always coming to Hollywood. And so I had this...
you just knew it? Head.
Yes, and everything I did, I was always performing. So it was... They said, where was the struggle there? And I pushed the struggle aside because I was living my life. Even when I arrived here and I was homeless, I was doing my workshops every day and cleaning up at the theater and hanging out with a quadriplegic guy on Hollywood and Vine. So I was totally blessed. And I met my wife the second day in Hollywood.
Second day in Hollywood. So how long have you both been married now?
We've been married, it's gonna be 49 years this year, but we've been together 50 years. As of March the 19th. I arrived March the 18th in 1969, and my friend that I had been in the production of Hair with in Mexico, in Acapulco, brought me to her door the second day.
Do you have a favorite piece here abode?
This is the latest one, and that's over there is Chulo, and over here is Chula. And that's kind of my homage to the where the woman is smoking her cigar and having her drink. And I was born a feminist, so I've always known that women are smarter than men.
I like that, everyone. Can you repeat that?
and over here, you're saying, which is my favorite? I really like this one. It is No Place Like Home.
No Place Like Home.
Which is very apropos for our house. And it's, and as you can see, the suitcase has the different cities where I worked in Rome and Hollywood and Mykonos and Dubrovnik and Yugoslavia, Miami, New York.
And so you left Southern California. Is this like your home?
Yes. I love Coachella Valley Desert here, where we are.
The desert community.
It's incredible and having you guys. So, once again, these are the Sergio Bustamante paper mache animals that you see here. He's a famous artist from Mexico. But life is art, and you'll be seeing the documentary fairly soon, so be on the lookout.
Be on the lookout. Pepe Serna, everyone, how blessed are we that he's willing to share his love, his passion, and I love how he said, I knew from the beginning, this is what I needed to do and be.
Yes.
We are blessed to know you. Thank you for sharing
Maria, thank you.
Goodbye.